lady in the community once said to me, as long as there's been a Maggie Valley, there's been whiskey made in Maggie Valley.
Whiskey making is an art. There's some people that has made for years and still can't make whiskey.
It takes time to make liquor. If you get moonshine off somebody, you need to know something about the person. Are you taking a chance if you don't?
As a kid, you know, we'd see Popcorn Sutton selling whiskey on the side of the roads. He'd have a big old jar full of cherries, and there'd be some kind of event going to town. He'd scoop out a cherry and sell it for $2 a cherry, and people loved that. And it just, you knew what it was, and it was just accepted.
They kept everything right there. They didn't have to come to Waynesville or anywhere much. Once in a while they did, but not much. Mm-hmm. Most of the time when they did come to Waynesville, they was delivering their goods.
And then pick up their goods.
Yeah.
Take back like salt and pepper and usually.
Yeah, right.
Flour, because yes. They make their own meal and everything else, raise their hogs.
The necessities that they,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah, they had to get the sugar.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Liquor rolling.
Well, it's kind of like a lost art. Nobody does it much anymore. There used to be a lot of that around here. That's where the people that I knew when I was here and back in the 60s, that's how they raised their family. And they fed their family like that. Wasn't nothing else to do around here but make moonshine. So it's kind of a tradition right in this part of the country.
Day, you know, this area was settled by Irish and Scottish immigrants that came into the area, and they just brought their craft with them. It was just part of what they did. And so it is neat to talk with people that, you know, have been around that can remember those days.
Back before propane, going back 100 years ago, there wasn't such thing as propane. They used wood. They'd use wood. And that's the reason they made it of a night, because you've got to smoke. And the revenues would look for a smoke in the mountains. If he seen a smoke in the mountains, he'd figure a still was being run. Now, that's a dead giveaway.
In the 30s of the Depression, they didn't even know what a depression was, because they lived that way all the time.
It was.
You know, so then everybody had their little enterprises. Everybody growed what to eat. Everybody was there for survival, and they helped each other.
You've probably seen Junior Johnson on NASCAR run around that little 40 Ford coupe.
Mm-hmm.
The cars we drove with them. Blew the fenders off of that thing. I ordered a new 61 Chevrolet from a factory, the full racing package. Revenues took it.
You could take whiskey, trade for anything. Flour, coffee, stuff you couldn't grow, sugar, women. Come in handy.
Whiskey making is an art. There's some people that has made for years and still can't make whiskey. I sell sipping whiskey, not selling whiskey. Anybody that gets our whiskey, I want them to taste. If they don't like it, I'll keep it. But I want them to know that I want a satisfied customer. I want it to be good.
If you can't drink it, you don't need it.
Yeah, you don't want somebody to go down the road and say, that's the damnest stuff I ever drunk. I don't even want more of that. Mm-hmm. See, and that gives you a bad rep.
Whiskey brings memories up. You know, it's something, it's something that you celebrate with. It's something you enjoy talking with friends and socializing with. It's not something you guzzle. It's something you sip, and you savor and you enjoy. So I love drinking whiskey, especially when I'm with others and we can just enjoy time together.
That's not supposed to be a banjo song.
Don't know.